Dan the Wolfman here, aka with the one and only New York Badass. What's up, Phil?
What's up, Dan?
How are you doing, buddy? Tell me what's been going on with you. You've been like a couple years, you were spending a lot of time in Thailand. Now you're at AKA. How long have you been here?
Really? Well, I've been here, you know, on and off since 2006 when I was fighting pride.
Okay.
So, you know, I've trained a lot. I'm real familiar with the team and the guys and what goes on here.
Are you going back and forth, just coming here for fight prep, like for a couple months before your fights, or are you living here now?
Mainly like 6 to 8 weeks before a fight, I come here to get ready for, you know, what I got coming up next. And then, you know, in the off season, I train a lot in Vegas at a street tour. I like to get away to focus on the fights. I get pretty aggressive and a poor wife like to get on our little.
Oh, okay. Well, geez, you know, you gotta keep things straight, keep your head in the game. How do you like training here? As far as the stand, let's talk about the standard. As far as the standard,
oh, the stands look great. The stand is great.
Yeah.
Javier Mendez is a world champion kickboxer. They had Jasper, who's an unbelievable Muay Thai instructor, and they have Skinny Javier from Colombia, who's a great boxing coach. I mean, they have stand up, great stand up. It's a great stand up champion.
And we just did a couple hour grappling class with a Brazilian guy. I don't know his name, but it was a pretty cool class.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great class. I mean, I was a really good instructor. Checking, you know, which is, I don't know anything about Jiu-Jitsu in Brazil.
No, well, that's
supposed to be a big, you know, a big time Jiu-Jitsu in Brazil. And, you know, it's really good. I think our Jiu-Jitsu is going up another level here as a team. I think our Jiu-Jitsu is unbelievable. I think with Daniel Cormier, our wrestling is going to be top notch. I don't think we'll compete with wrestling. And like you said earlier, our striking is, you know, we're known for that. So. I think it's a pretty well-rounded
game. And you're doing the grappling game down. I mean, you rolled around. I rolled around with you, around with Fitch, and around with some young up-and-coming guy. So, you know, it was good stuff.
Yeah.
How long did we go back?
We go back since on the ground. I was looking to fight Matt Lindman, the first fight Matt Lindman. I went to Michigan, Central Michigan, my college wrestling teams. I had no way to train. And this guy contacted me on the underground and said, hey, you need to work out partner. And he was all, ended up holding mitts for me. He was my jiu-jitsu instructor.
Well, cool. So what's going on with you? So you're getting ready for a couple fights or something? What's going on?
Yeah, I have a fight in Ring of Fire against Chris the Hammer Holland.
In Colorado?
In Denver, yeah.
Denver, okay.
And I'm getting ready for that fight. I'm really preparing for that fight right now. I'm at a crossroads in my career right now. I really need to win. And I'm trying to go hard for this fight. I'm not looking past this guy, but I'm looking through this guy. I'm going to go through this guy like shit through a goose bar. And, you know, I'm looking to fight about 3 or 4 weeks later, possibly in 1FC or SFL. You know what I mean? I just want to keep going, get the ball rolling, knock some guys out.
Yeah, get that win and get some more international experience. I mean, you got tons of what you bring. I mean, you're the real fucking Rocky, in my opinion, because you bring it every time. I mean, who's not a fan of football? I mean, every fight's good.
If you're a fight fan, you're a fan of Phil Baroni. If you don't like the badass, you must not be a fight fan.
And that's the way to do it. So here at AK, you guys look forward to me now.com. I'm going to be checking out Strike Force tomorrow night. And subscribe to my YouTube page at DanTheWolfman1. Get 500 instructional videos. Thanks, Phil. And now we're going to go check out and get a ride to, you know, Phil's going to hook me up with a ride in the Swoop Deep.